Hello everyone. I want to say thank you for joining me today. This is my very first astrology podcast. I have been an astrologer for a lot of years and I'm very excited to bring this to you today. So the transits are what we're going to talk about today and how different times in the month will impact your life, the good, the do's, the don'ts. And so let's go. July 1st through the 5th is Mars and Saturn are square to each other. And it's like driving with the brakes on. So you could be caught in traffic. Whatever it is that you're trying to do seems to meet with a delay. So plan on that delay. Do not plan on everything to go perfectly. You'll be able to work with this energy as long as you don't get too egotistical. So, you know, if you decide to ride on the shoulder of the expressway and because you're tired of sitting and waiting in traffic, Saturn may be the police officer that comes up behind you in his car and gives you a ticket. So it's really a good time not to challenge authority figures, and it's only for 4 days. Keep yourself out of trouble, please. Let's look at July 6th through the 9th when Venus is squaring Saturn. Venus square Saturn is when Venus is frustrated by like the authority. Again, coldness. Saturn is cold. Venus is all love. So it's a time in our lives when money and relationships seem to be colder. They seem to not work out as well. But it is, again, it's Venus is moving very quickly. So from the 6th through the 9th, try not to make any big purchases. You would probably regret them with that Saturn. Also, Venus square Saturn can bring some sort of news about a love relationship or money situation that is not going to make you happy. So again, don't do anything to cause problems. And whatever you are dealing with, it is a fantastic time to put yourself on a money diet, on a food diet. It makes it very, very easy to start a disciplinary routine for yourself around your beauty, around your health, around your happiness. Or July 12th through the 14th, we have Venus and Mars conjunct. Venus is the Empress, people, and Mars is the Emperor. We have divine energy. So it is in Leo. All the fire and air signs will really enjoy the energy. For love and action, for the earth and water signs, you'll have to make some adjustments, baby. But it really shows that it's a beautiful time. It's a wonderful time. Many people who have a significant Leo placement will find their partner at this time. So it's a great time to have weddings and parties and children. And it's all about the fun, really going for the gold. It's the Emperor and Empress entertaining lavishly at home and really enjoying everyone and everyone that's there at the event. Chiron. So Chiron is a planet of healing and it is stationary for July 15th and 16th. So it means that it's not going to really help you heal. The takeaway on this is that it's not a good time to stand on a swivel chair and decide you're going to adjust your curtain. You're not going to have a good result. So just pay attention. Just be extra careful on the 15th and 16th. The 17th and 18th, Pluto is opposing the Sun. The best way to describe this is power struggles. Pluto is, you know, life and death. It's the death card. It's Scorpio energy. And the Sun is Leo energy. It's all about big and bold and life. So it just says that if you get into some sort of ego-driven battle with an authority figure, whoever the authority figure is probably going to damage the person who is using the Sun energy to be playful and have fun. So it's not a good time to push the limit. It's not a good time, for instance, to drink and drive. It would be. And if you get into an argument with your boss, you may not have a result right then, but you could find yourself in a layoff situation or being fired at some time if the company decided to let people go. So it really is important to lay low that day. Just lay low, keep your ego in check. And as the movie line is don't let your ego write checks that your body can't cash. Don't get in a bad argument just because you want to have your way. July 24th, we have a new beautiful moon in Aquarius incredibly beautiful energy. It's a great time for joining groups. It's a great time for expanding anything to do with electronics, electronic learning. Jupiter is very expansive in terms of like esoteric. It can be the studies if you want to study astrology. If you want to study, you know, traditional religion or philosophy, it's great. It's really great for those who might want to take an online learning class. Just keep the rest of the aspects in mind. You don't want to overdo it with your budget. Don't take on what you can't handle. July 27th through the 30th, Mark, the Jupiter opposite Mars. Now, Jupiter opposite Mars means that most likely somebody is going to chase you romantically, and it might not be somebody you want to have romantically chasing you. So it can be an energy that's fantastic. It can be so much fun. It is an energy that says, let's go whitewater rafting. Let's go, you know, do something really fun. Let's make a little love, do a little dance, get down tonight. It's really like overdoing it. So if you don't want the consequences of drinking too much, partying too much, spending too much money, just keep that in mind and guide yourself accordingly. When we have July 28th through the December 29th. Jupiter does return to Aquarius. It is a wonderful time to expand your horizons, to join groups. For many of you, if you're involved in any kind of friendship group, any kind of meetup group, any kind of group that learns or does humanitarian projects, it's a beautiful time to expand all of that. And if you aren't currently in a group, it's a really beautiful time to join a group. It would really advance what you want advanced at this time. It will bring you new knowledge, it will bring you new ideas, and it will be the cutting edge of the life as you want to write it. So that is the energy of July for everyone. Sending you love. Send some back, tell me where you're from, and tell me what you think of this podcast. If it was helpful, if it wasn't, I just so appreciate all of you and your support. Thank you so much. Take care.